Welcome to another episode of Back to Basics. I'm Akash Bhatia, and today we'll be looking at architecting for private workloads. Cloud has fundamentally changed the way the applications are designed and developed by making resources available on demand and via internet. However, there are certain niche use cases that have an inherent requirement to be private and not be accessible over shared domains. These workloads can range from security and defense to finance to personal health. In this video, we'll look at some of the principles and patterns how to architect for such unique workloads. Let's start by reviewing some of the unique aspects required by these workloads. The sensitive nature of these workloads and often related regulatory guidelines mandate enterprise-level controls and boundaries, designing for non-public connectivity and enhanced real-time maintainability via centralized monitoring and auditing. In order to realize these, the three fundamental foundational pillars are structuring management and governance through AWS organization and organizational units, or OUs, enabling control through policy control mechanisms ranging from guardrails like service control policies and IAM permission boundaries to grants such as resource-based policies and access control lists, and quick nationalization through cloud-enabled native services like AWS Private Link and Amazon AppFlow. With that, let's dive deeper into what an end-to-end architecture would look like. We start with one of the foundational management and governance services, AWS Organization. AWS Organization allows to centrally manage and govern your environment as you scale your AWS resources, whether through programmatic APIs or workflow organization. It is an account management service that lets you consolidate multiple AWS accounts into an organizational unit. With organizations, you can create a new member account or invite existing accounts to join your organization. You can organize those accounts into groups and attach centralized or specialized policy-based controls to these groups. In our architecture, we have three OUs. Foundation infrastructure, which is horizontal across the organization and houses centralized logging, security, and network services. Second is public workload organizational unit, which usually houses generic workloads that do not require the same sensitivities. And finally, we have private workload OU, which houses sensitive applications divided by respective categories. To simplify governance at scale, AWS provides AWS Control Tower. AWS Control Tower provides the easiest way to set up and govern a secure multi-account AWS environment called Landing Zone. It creates your landing zone using AWS Organization, providing ongoing account management and governance, and implement best practices based on AWS's experience of working with thousands of customers. The advantage of using AWS Organization and organizational units is that it allows for application of policies at a higher level. One such example of organizational policy is service control policies, which can be applied at organization root, organizational unit, or even at individual accounts. These differ from IAM policies, which are usually applied to users, groups, or roles, and hence provide for standardization across enterprise structures. Now let's dive deeper into some of the cloud-native services we discussed earlier. AWS Private Link provides for private connectivity between virtual private clouds or VPCs, other AWS services, and on-premise networks without exposing your traffic to the public internet. AWS Private Link makes it easy to connect different services across multiple accounts and VPCs to significantly simplify your network architectures. Amazon AppFlow automates data flows by securely integrating third-party applications and AWS services without code, usually between SaaS services like Salesforce, SAP, Slack, and ServiceNow, and AWS services like Amazon S3 and Amazon Redshift. AppFlow automatically encrypts data in motion and allows users to restrict data from flowing over the public internet for SaaS applications that are integrated with AWS Private Link, thereby reducing exposure to security threats. In this episode, we explored how to architect for such private workloads which demand more granularity and control over how they are architected. These practices help significantly reduce the security threats for such applications. As always, security is job zero at AWS. Check out the links below for more details. Thanks for watching this Back to Basics. See you next time.